I wanted to talk about the baby boom. And the reason why is, you know, so many are retiring and so many have already retired. And there's kind of a big, you know, there's quite a several years of age difference and who the baby boom is. And even some of those older than the baby boom. And the reason why is they have a lot to do with what went on and how the why social societies the way it is. Why it got changed so severe compared to, not saying it's better, I never was alive before, you know, the baby boomers, but big, serious changes in corruption and culture. They changed the culture a lot. And morals, moral law, even politics, you know, the whole institution, church, Christian ministry, politics, security got really changed around. And then even the whole China thing has been about, you know, the baby boomers started that, so. And I just want to talk, say a few things about it. I can't, like, go into too much detail and why, you know, I mean, there's so much to this world that would be taking me forever, you know, to pinpoint the exact times and dates of everything. And so I just want to... just want to touch base, say a few words. So, baby boom, like, my parents are baby boomers. My dad was like right on the edge of baby boom and not the older generation than the baby boom, and my mom was in the baby boom. She's a few years younger. And the thing about the baby boom, World War, now, their parents, my grandparents, they were like pioneer age. I mean, my grandmother came over to Oregon in a wagon train and covered wagon from Eureka, California. So they're a little different, and they were like raised kids really strict about Christian traditional American behavior. But they were such hypocrites. I think way much more so than their parents. Because of the World War. And television. And the Jews had a lot to do with the culture changing. They trying to trick people. And I think that what they did with Hollywood, Dick Clark had a lot to do with things changing around. He was a lot bigger role player than many people would believe, but I think he wasn't really doing anything himself, but he was the man who, with the mission. You know what I mean? As far as that, he had it together. He figured things out. And then people took that and, like, got really creepy, right? Did their thing a creepy way. He did things his way. They did things their way. They got creepy. And it's got creepier, creepier. And they were, like, hiding all kinds of things from people. And he'd do like this plain normal thing and come up with, yeah, this is a talk show, right? And he's just talking about normal things, right? But like they got like their thing going and they're doing like these creepy things, right? And then like his American Bandstand, he was like normal, and then like he'd bring the musicians on and they were like creepy. And he's like, oh, okay, goodbye. You know, oh, this, thank you, Prince. You sissy guy. Well, let's get the next contestant on. You know, I don't know. And it was just ongoing, you know. I mean, he'd grin and bear it and share it, you know, but we'd all kind of, you know, I mean, I don't know, some people seem to have really taken all that serious. I mean, they're I don't know, there's like everybody, some people have different intellects and or different prowess or different perspective, maybe a different understanding, or just don't believe in God very well, you know, which is perfectly normal in this world because of the way things are. You know, you have to just have that calling, you know, somehow mysteriously you're called, but or God brings you to a point in your life where you start believing in being a creator. There's somebody in your life who believes, whatever. And I don't know exactly when the worst of things started happening, but with Hitler, you know, and the World War, and they had drafted so many people, and so many, there's so much difference in the world order. I mean, you had these intellects, these mad scientists coming about, and Himmler, who knows what kind of, you know, they're trying all kinds of stuff with genetics and trying to prove these people are, you know, they're trying to kill the weak and get rid of all the bad, sick people that got bad genetics, all kinds of things, right? You know, and killing the Jews off. And, but that was about world order and stuff and ethnic cleansing and, you know, their principalities and order of their country. And Jews were all over the place. And, you know, the Spanish Inquisitioners did it, but to get rid of them out of their monarchies because the Jews had become... So even in during, before Christ in Rome, there was Jews who had worked up to be generals and married into royal families of Spain and Portugal and different places, right? And, yeah, so this is like before Christ, right? And then those people, though, like after Christ, eventually those families, you know, they were real prominent families, originated from Israelite families in Israel. Become like they call them Ashkenazi Jew. But they had been in Spain and Portugal a lot, and so I don't know where they all did. They tried to exile a lot of families, get rid of them out of their ethnic cleansing and their royal families. And Hitler was doing something similar, but Hitler was like this guy that was a witch. He was an artist, an art witch from Vienna. And lived in Vienna and homeless and like got really whatever kind of witches he got involved with and hatred for people who are rich and royal families and stuff. I mean, he like, I don't know what went through his mind, you know. He must have been on like serious drugs, and then like an art witch would be, you know. There's still a lot of black magic art witches and stuff in Vienna, and now these Hitler people and this stuff, you know, it's a lot's going on. They're getting really like strict in America where it's Christian, right? And they got like people, nobody could like marry somebody from a different race or kind of like Spanish. I mean, it was like they were like really, really segregated, right? And I mean, it didn't matter. Like, you're Italian, because we had to put Germans and Japanese in concentration camps, and they're getting, like, really strict. So I think, and that's the parents of the baby boomers, right? And then, so the parents are being really strict on their kids. And (clears throat) that are being born like right towards the end of the World War, or at, you know, at right after the World War, and then the Cold War hit, right? And see, my grandma, she told me, she's the World War, like, kind of, you know what I mean? So they would have been fighting in the World War when their kids were being born, right? My grandfather had been drove a cat, like one of those cats that have caterpillars, they're called, at a logging camp for the Conservation Corps. And so, because his father owned a logging company, and then his father died when he was young, though, and he didn't get to, like, work for his father's logging company, but his uncle had a logging company, too, because my great-grandfather and my great-great-uncle, his brother, both had logging companies. And then they owned, like, part of the college, and there was, like, a lot of kids, and I think they had, like, you know, only 10 kids in that family. My grandfather's aunt, she, like, the college went bankrupt during the Depression, and she got a job at Berkeley as a music teacher, and she was the first woman teacher at Berkeley and the first woman music teacher at Berkeley. And college, which is the best music college in the U.S. And so kind of historical family stuff. They're real pioneers, you know. But my grandfather, he worked as a logger, and the loggers for the Conservation Corps didn't have to go fight in the war. He is a short guy. He's not, I mean, like, large in stature at all. And, you know, road promoting and logging had been his family's heritage. And so I think he was married and had a kid already by the time the war hit. I don't know. My dad was the last kid born, and he was born in, like, 44 or something. 43 or 44. And I think he's at least 10 years apart. His brother, sister might have been older than that. I don't know. 12 years. Something like, you know, I mean, anyways, he was already starting a family, or at least been thinking about it. My grandmother, he had already been logging. He was already a logger before the war, I'm pretty sure, because my grandmother, she met him at a logging camp. She worked at a restaurant that brought food to him, to the loggers. Her and her sister both worked at the restaurant, and they would bring food. So they started dating my grandfather and his friend. And, like, all the way until they died, they were, like, his sister and his... My grandmother's sister and his friend lived in the same little retirement court place. Neighbors. But, I had a conversation with my grandmother before she died about things, and she said that I'd asked her if she would like to go to church or what, you know, because she was getting old, and she had like a broken hip, and she was like just staying home and watching TV and playing solitaire, watch court TV all day. And the Lutheran church was around the corner, but she didn't want to go. She told me why, because she was raised really, really strict, and by the Lutherans in Dakota, in North Dakota. And she said she couldn't wait to get out of the home, and she didn't want to live on the farm. There was too many chores, and so that's why my grandfather didn't live like out country. He lived in town because she didn't like it. She didn't like chores. So, like, she'd make everybody TV dinner so she wouldn't have to cook, kind of thing, you know. They all go out to the restaurant or whatever. She wasn't going to cook and do dishes if she didn't have to. But my other grandfather, mother, was the opposite way. Was the pioneer. She loved a big garden, loved to cook for everybody. We have barbecues all the time. don't know. They were both a cheap. One grandma was Scandinavian, the other one was like Scottish, French, English, and Irish mix. So, Scandinavian grandmother is the one I'm talking to, Lutheran and Dakotas, and she's the one that hated chores from living on a farm and how strict her parents were. And so she raised my parents, my dad, and his sisters and brothers. She didn't want to be strict because her parents were strict, but she at least sent them to church. So it was like gradual, right? She sent them to church. My dad was like, I think they went to Lutheran church, the first of them. But then when my dad was born, she had decided Jesus going to send him to like a non-denominational church, because the Lutheran church she was kind of upset about because they were so strict. And then, so, you know, you can see how it's gradually changing by generation. And then you got the Hitler stuff going on. You know, then we had the civil rights movements, and we had some weird stuff, because like a lot of Jewish people were moving to the country. They're Jews in Hollywood, they're Jews in California, and then boom, like they got this, like, I don't know, because they were so anti-Christian, Jewish people. When they came to U.S., they had freedom of religion, which they didn't have in other countries. So here, they just like went all out to go and total assault against the culture, right? And use Hollywood as a cultural beacon, right? And the television and the movies. A lot of them hid they were even Jewish. They changed their names. And if you go through, you don't know how many actors were actually Jewish that had names that were English or whatever. You know, Scottish or French or whatever, you know, anything but Jewish, because they changed their name. And so what happened was, like, eventually they got so much in the way of everything, because there's a lot of what Christian culture is, other than what you see on, like, television evangelicals, which was something kind of new. Society, I mean, we had our hypocrites and everything, but they couldn't, like, get on TV, you know, I mean, and so, now, like, they get on your TV and they don't get on YouTube, I don't know, but, what they did was got in the way of things, and witches somehow like came out of the woodwork, right? And witchcraft was like really anti-Christian and even against Jewish things, right? Well, so what they did was they had this guy Aleister Crowley and Golden Dawn, and they like took his stuff, because his stuff put Jewish knowledge, they had esoteric Jews and stuff, right? And they thought it was clever to put Jewish stuff in there to make it seem like they could be some kind of witch that has to do with Jewish religion or Christian religion, right? So then we got all these musicians and artists in Hollywood, these cultural people, the cultural leaders, into this Aleister Crowley, Golden Dawn, witchcraft stuff, right? The hippies jump on it. And a lot of Jews were hippies. So they're building communes like Aleister Crowley did. You got some weird stuff going on. And then they had Cold War. And you had KGB trying to help them out and plan this stuff out with them. Or get them to plan, find out which ones can plan things out and helping those guys out, giving them information or whatever, you know, using their agency to aid them in establishing their communes or whatever they can, right? To subvert culture, because that was their strategy. So a lot of it had to do with Cold War. The baby boom was like the Cold War experiment, right? Up to the KGB. And people don't realize it, but they gradually, you know, I mean, now I'm still meeting baby boomers and they've been on meth their whole life. They just, every porn, you know, as soon as porn hit, mafia porn hit, they were all into that, right? And they got the porn going in the country. There was no porn before the baby boom. And they got all that stuff going. The horror movies, you know, like the women are dressing half naked. That's all been the baby boomers. And it was the baby boom headbangers and rock and roll guys who are now like all, you know, did all the cocaine and got the cocaine into the country. And so these baby boomers are old, you know, you got to realize they were like social anarchists and rebellion and total subverted by the KGB and the Cold War. And they started it all, right? And they're not the same as the elders before. I met the elders before them. I knew people that were born in the 1800s because I still had my great-grandmother was still alive while I was a teen, until I was, you know, mid-teens. And then I had two great-great uncles and a great-great aunt that were alive. And I don't know how much different they were, you know. I'm not going to say it was any better, but they definitely had not known the kind of immoral stuff. It was unimaginable to them, you know. The things that these witchcraft, you know, was not what they had known nothing about witch culture or what the Jews were doing, right? With culture. And maybe the Freemasons would be, it was like a secret knowledge a Freemason might know. But most people weren't Freemason. So, I mean, we had their hypocrite preachers. I know my grandmother's father, he was one. You know, he was a preacher, Pentecostal preacher. And he got caught committing adultery on his dairy. One of the people from church caught him with some gal or something. I don't know. They're having an all-out orgy or something on the dairy. I don't know what it was. He got kicked out of town. Nobody heard from him in the family again. But, okay. Yeah, I don't know. It's kind of weird. But the baby boom is like, you know, what did all this stuff come from? And they're still, you know, Donald Trump and Bill Gates, and they all this China stuff we're going through, they started it. I mean, they exhausted the resources with the world. They sold a country out to China, and the whole country just was like not even America anymore after their parents died, my grandparents. They tried to change the identity of their parents, change the identity of their children, anybody who's Christian, the church. And they're called apostate. And so I think the apostasy that's talked about in the Gospels is really has to do with that World War stuff. I don't know. I can't say that for sure. I mean, like, I'm not saying that God gave me this great knowledge and I'm just reasoning this out. He did give me the ability to reason out. And it seems like, even though you read of all the evils, it just seems like all that stuff before Christianity, I mean, I think it was a lot more, most institution has been because of the church in America. The colleges, Harvard, Yale, it's about every state's colleges. A lot of colleges, the original ones, the hospitals were the Catholic Church was like the hospital institution. They were, that was their thing, nuns stuff. And I mean, they had, like, real medical knowledge before doctors, because the doctors were, like, these quack guys that come to your house not knowing a whole lot until they developed the science in the West, right? But the nuns, you know, they were, like, nurses and stuff. And had the hospitals. But I just wanted to talk about it, because what can you do? I mean, I just wanted to let, you know, share a few words about, it was really the baby boom, all this China stuff, and following them, leading, you know, listening to them, I couldn't fathom trusting them, you know, knowing that they're who did it, all of it. Especially the rock and roll headbangers, like Ozzy Osbourne's one, Iron Maiden, Metallica, Slayer, all of them, you know. Well, you know, some of those guys are a little younger. I'm not sure how old they are. The glam rockers, they're like younger baby boomers, but they're more of a Gen X, older Gen X, I think. I don't know. But you had the headbangers, the first headbangers, Black Sabbath, and then they were baby boomers. Beatles, Elvis. So the whole respect your elders and all that stuff in the Bible, I mean, you gotta be like really careful and pray. I mean, you have to respect everybody. You can't, you know, it says, you know, I don't know, like Bible teachings, you have to understand that, you know, world's the world and church, but with the baby boom, they made it harder because they'll believe they're the church, or that their parents are Christian, and what they believe, they changed the church around. It was the baby boom who started all the pedophilia stuff going on. And I don't know if that was like a satanic church, or the witches and the Jews like plotting and using people's kids to get involved who were Catholic and persecute everybody. So they used the baby boom to persecute the church as an institution, subvert, like ruin everything. I don't know if that kind of is like an ultimate plan. We're going along with the culture, the Jews, the hippies, the sexual revolution. All that stuff was kind of Aleister Crowley, I think. And to get rid of Christianity so they can bring in paganism. Jews, too. Get away from Christian families. The heritage of real American people, right? Culture. Sell out to China. So out to the world, they hit it, because the Jews, like, they didn't care about any country or kind. And so they're bringing up all the evils they can bring up, and all the injustices they can think of, right? There's a scripture that says, the wicked dig up evil. It's like a proverb in the Bible. And that's kind of what people are doing, but I don't know. I just wanted to talk about the baby boom. That's the baby boom, you know. This is all baby boom stuff. All the bad, weird stuff that are un-American and against every other country. They did it to Germany. They did it to every country they can. So, you gotta, I don't know, I pray for my parents. I still talk to my parents. I love my parents. It's been like Darth Vader and Luke Skywalker, though. You know, I mean, like, wasn't Luke, like, from the same family, and his innocent uncles and aunts, but then, like, his father was, like, Darth Vader, and they both had the Force, but, like, Luke was, like, he joined the real fight, and the good guys, and Darth Vader was on the bad side, right? And that was his father, so that kind of happened to a lot of baby... Because of the baby boom, that happened to a lot of people, where, like, Luke, I am your father. No, no, it's not true. You know, and we have like 30 million basketball kids now. And they're all like, when they meet their father, to be like, I'm your father. And they're like, no, no, it's not true. Like Luke and Darth Vader. How's the baby him though? Anyways, pray. My suggestion would be pray for everybody. And, I guess we have to forgive. But we need to acknowledge that, you know, so we're not misled and living, like, you know, they're the grace there of God, or the examples, or really, that their demonic wisdom is the wisdom of the elders of God's true heritage, right? And, something like that.